Hey, happy Wednesday, everybody. Mark again here at Weatherman Plus. And I got a big update on what's going on with this next pattern. Just like I told you yesterday, that we need to watch this system as all this brings over towards the southern half of the Gulf of Mexico, potentially get broken up into parts. And now we're seeing that once we get that front going right along here, a little stalled front, that we're going to have pieces breaking off from this disturbance we're looking at. One piece is going to go into the Gulf of Mexico. It's been trending over here by Louisiana or towards Florida. And one's going to go over here towards Mexico, maybe come around towards the southwest, maybe go all the way into the Pacific, and maybe even go even far toward the west. But what I'm seeing is that this is going to bring some storms and maybe even form up something into the Gulf. Now, I haven't seen anything strong as of yet. The strongest I've seen and trending multiple runs after run is the artificial intelligence of the Euro showing a strong tropical storm, and now it's trending with other models as well. So I'm going to go through all this information with you, as well as what is the artificial intelligence of the Euro and what the possibilities are. I'm going to show you all the information in this video, that way you know what to expect. I have a lot of links down below on what I'm about to show you, and you can do a lot of reading for yourself on what has been reported. Now, we are still sitting at the 30% for right now. Matter of fact, I believe this will hang around, maybe even go down to 20 for a little while and be around the western Gulf of Mexico. Then we're going to see it start stretching. Then we're going to see a stretch come out like this on possible formation of the system. Maybe something along the east coast as well, but this is going to be traveling into that direction. I don't really see impacts from that. But I think we will see something forming around the Gulf of Mexico in the coming days. Still showing chance for a tropical depression with the Euro. You can see chances for something go into the eastern Pacific and still something form up in the western Gulf of Mexico. This has gone a little bit further to the north, just like we've seen with the Icon. Icon is still showing something starting right here, literally in 4 to 5 days. I'm thinking we could have both. So as we go 4 days to 5 days, you can see it consolidates down here. And what we really have is we have that piece of wave that's going to go south, and we have this wave that's going to go north. And these two are still going to meet up as you go 6 days and 7 days. Now it's going to start headed north as you go towards the 12th and 13th. Showing in 10 days, it is going to be on the move. Still showing towards the north or northeastern side of the Gulf of Mexico right after that. So when we look at the ensembles, you can see in 72 hours that low pressure just hanging right off the Gulf Coast as our system moves across the Yucatan. And when it gets into the Bay of Campeche, you can see it all starts bundling up, especially as we go towards 6 days. Now here we are at 6 days. It's in agreement where it's going to be at, more than likely. Now this could feed off a little bit to the west, lose a little bit of the energy a few days after that. Then shortly after that, we'll see more activity. See how those shoot off to the west. Then once we get around the 13th, the 12th and the 13th, this is where the transition happens. So a lot of this energy has already gone off to the west, the majority of the energy, and what's left tries to form up something as we go in the coming days, showing chances for tropical storm, showing a chance for a hurricane, but hurricane is not trending. Tropical storm is what is trending. As we push forward, you can see where this wave is going to be going to after it goes to that western push. So you can see the pattern here as you go almost towards 3 days with the Euro. We have our trough coming in with our cool front. We have that system moving across the Yucatan. And you see, according to the Euro, it breaks apart pieces. And that's what goes east while we get a system going towards the west, showing maybe at the last minute formation, get a spin up around the eastern side of the Gulf of Mexico. But once again, as this goes into the eastern Pacific, creates a system, you can see with the Euro, it runs out of time and you literally have something very weak, according to the Euro. Nothing that y'all cannot handle, anywhere from a tropical depression to a tropical storm, just bringing y'all a good bit of rainfall. And the winds will start adding up once you become that strong tropical storm and moving upwards. But I don't see any major hurricane come out of this. But you see how it goes on land and stays strong all the way towards Tennessee and Kentucky Valley as that moves to the north. So this is going to impact multiple people, but showing weakness on the Euro. Showing with the same thing with the GFS. You can see the piece breaking off while you get that piece going into the eastern Pacific and potentially coming right across to southwest. You see this big high ridge? This would pull this to the north after it goes to the west. So this would bring either more storms across the Four Corners or even further west and bring more storms towards California and Arizona. And you can see the same thing with GFS. It is trending. Once you go from the 10th on, you get your system in the eastern Pacific. Then you get that piece that comes across a trough into the eastern Gulf of Mexico, showing the same thing as a Euro lately. Very weak systems pushing through on that opportunity. Now, when we take a look at the Euro artificial intelligence, this is something new that they put out quite some time ago, but it is a newer model. And what it is it's factoring ensembles also into the weather model. I have some information for you. You can go read. It's been showing the last four runs consecutively that this is going to build up and become a stronger system like a tropical storm in the Gulf, and not something very weak. It has a lot of measurements in this ensemble. But once again, this is artificial intelligence of the Euro. Now, I do have the link in the description for you. You can go read about this. The artificial intelligence of the Euro consists of the deterministic model and an ensemble model. So remember, I have links in the description so you can go read what's going on with this weather model has been put out there, and it is highly accurate. Matter of fact, it's more accurate long range than the other Euro deterministic model. This is a very good model. Now, the one thing that this model does do is it makes predictions on wind, temperature, humidity, geo potential height, and more. Matter of fact, it is more accurate than the other models when it comes to geo potential height. So it's already starting to overcome what it already is trying to replace. And another thing that this model does do is it knocks out the noise out of the forecasting. So as you have a lot of smoothing going on, because you can't tell exactly the transition that's going on, you just see a rough pattern, this model will give you more detail within that forecast. That's why we're seeing more accurate information, and it'll show you in the ensembles of that model what is the potential problems that could be affecting the forecast. So it has a lot of great potential. Now, it's too much to go into this video what all is being done with this model and how great this model is actually turning out. So I have links in the description so you can go read about it, see everything that's going into this model, what the design is, also the latest information from CSU, why this hyperactive hurricane season is not hyperactive, and they give you a bunch of reasons why it's not going the way they're saying. And if it is still going to be the way they're saying, then we can expect 18 named systems coming with the rest of this hurricane season. And remember, other than this weak system, potentially a tropical storm forming into the Gulf of Mexico, it will be quiet for the rest of September, and this is going to be historically low. But once again, this link is in the description. Go down, read it. You can see all the information, all the excuses and reasons why we don't have this hyperactive over crazy hurricane season right now. Now, you can see the latest information or potential velocity anomaly with GFS looking for lift, some favorable environment. As we go from the 10th, you can see right here when we look towards our Gulf of Mexico, showing that system will be western, more likely be either into Mexico, the lower 48 on southwest. And then after that, potentially a little more centered of the Gulf of Mexico around the 10th to the 12th. Still showing that. And you can still see the same thing with the Euro as well from the 10th through the 12th, showing right in our Gulf of Mexico. So I am still showing that this piece is still going to break off and something is going to come out of that. And showing before that is a lot of weakness. Something going across the Pacific weak, and something going across that front out into the Atlantic, something weak. From the 10th through the 12th is when this transition is going to happen. And no, this does not change anything on my long range neither. You can see the update here on the long range with the Euro, showing these two systems. Also, maybe something coming into the 20s with the same scenario, but weaker. And that system that's coming in October, still showing that's going to be further to the west, and maybe something forming into the Atlantic. Still showing a historically low and quiet peak of our hurricane season. Matter of fact, I talked about this 12 days ago and 2 weeks ago about how this was going to be a banger of a hurricane season or is going to be a bust. Now, you do see from the 11th through the 15th, they do have a risk for flooding in all of this white region and a slight risk for heavy rainfall in all of this green during this time. While we're expecting tropical cyclone formation in the southern half of the Gulf, it's going to be predicted for above average rainfall for y'all. But I'm still showing that we're going to get that system spinning up right on the eastern or the northern side of the Gulf of Mexico. So far showing that the buildup will be anywhere around southern Texas, along the Gulf Coast, getting a little bit heavier, more inland for Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama. Mississippi and Alabama, y'all could use the rainfall the most. And going right across Florida, but just like I showed you yesterday, northern Florida, Georgia, y'all going to be in on it the heaviest on this transition. That is with GFS. You can see with the Euro showing almost the exact same thing. So it is bringing, in the least, a lot of heavy rainfall. But I'm showing some of these storms are going to start bursting up. And right over here is where we're going to have potential formation at the last minute. And you can see from our drought monitor that we don't have extreme or exceptional really in this region. A little bit from northern Mississippi, some of Tennessee. And we do have severe in this tannish orange color as you get all this heavy rainfall. So this will go away. Matter of fact, when you look at this 3-month expected drought outlook, you can see that your drought removal in all of this green is likely. So starting today, you do have the chance for the flash flooding, and it is increasing. So you have the marginal for today. You have the slight risk going all the way from Houston all the way towards Mississippi and Louisiana, and the marginal going towards Florida. For tomorrow, this is going to move over a little bit. It's still going to be sitting here bringing the storms on the eastern side of this. So you definitely got to watch out for the storms. But you got the marginal. You got the slight risk. This is for tomorrow. This is for Thursday. And bringing that marginal over towards Florida. And as you go towards Friday, this is going to transition some more. Still in the slight risk from Louisiana towards the panhandle of Florida. But the marginal is going growing towards Georgia and the Carolinas now. This is going to go on even longer. So I'm still showing we need to watch this system as what's going to happen with this front when it starts ripping it apart. It's going to start getting some spin going with it. And this is where we could get something in that very warm Gulf waters. But remember, we got this cool front coming down. This is going to cool off a little bit of the Gulf Coast of the waters. So the warmest will be out here as it crosses across the Gulf. It won't be that last minute intensification to a Cat 3, I do not believe. If anything, a tropical storm. Thank you for your time, everybody. Remember, all the links are in the description below so you can go read about everything I have showed you. And what do y'all think about this AI, this artificial intelligence of the Euro? It's becoming more accurate than the regular models. So that looks like something we're going to have coming in the future, which is a great thing. A little more accuracy would be even better. If this information has helped you in any way, please consider hitting that subscribe button. Make sure you click that bell and select all. That way you get all notifications. Otherwise, you'll only hear about it once a week or every 2 weeks from me. That's the way it is with YouTube now. Thank you again for your time. Consider hitting that like button and help another person just like yourself see this information. I appreciate every single one of y'all. Now, before you go today, a quick word from our Father. 1 Timothy 2, 1 through 6. I exhort, therefore, that first of all, supplications, prayers, intercessions, and giving of thanks be made for all men, for kings and for all that are in authority, that we may lead a quiet and peaceful life in all godliness and honesty. For this is good and acceptable in the sight of God our Savior, who will have all men to be saved and to come unto the knowledge of the truth. For there is one God and one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus, who gave himself a ransom for all to be testified in due time. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I will see you first thing in the morning. And I believe afternoon updates could be starting soon if this continues to trend. I appreciate every single one of y'all, and remember, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh, and I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life. and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. If you have a moment, go to my community tab on my page. I'm doing something new to my channel soon. And there's a little poll out there I want you to be a part of. Thank you so much.